Well, howdy, everybody. I'm J Sadie Gray, and I'm here with my sister, Lenny. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Well, today, we're talking about the Amen Corner. But first, we have Lily and Lily singing, Be Encouraged. Churches, they have a section called the Amen Corner. This is the area that most of the people sit who talk to the preacher while he's preaching. They'll say comments like, preach it, yes, that's right, or amen. And they're agreeing with the preacher, and they're encouraging him. And I was thinking the other day, we all need an Amen Corner in our lives. People who will encourage us to keep on going, and encourage us that we are doing good. There are plenty of people out there who will tell you how you should have done something different, but there are people who have the gift of encouragement, and they know when you need to be told, attaboy. God bless them. They are doing what the Bible states in 1 Thessalonians 5:11. So encourage each other and give each other strength, just as you are doing now. And that's from the New Century Version. And we thank God for these people. And we enjoy the Book of Ruth because it tells the true story of two women named Ruth and Naomi. And throughout the book, they encourage each other, especially through a time of sorrow and a time of lack. God has promised us in the book of Hebrew, He will never forsake us. You know, there could be a time when there is not an encourager around the second you need them. But God's word is a word of encouragement that is always around. It is also good to take time and get into the word of God. It will encourage your soul if you're saved. And if you're not saved and you want to be, just pray this prayer with me. Dear Heavenly Father, please forgive me of my sins. I believe Jesus is your son, and that he died on the cross and rose from the dead. Please take my life and do something good with it. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, if you believed what you prayed, you're saved. Thank the Lord. And reading the Bible will help your faith to grow. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Well, we have another song for you. Here is Walt Mills singing, Love Lifted Me.
From the peaceful shore, and very deeply stained within, I was sinking to rise no more. But the master
got another poem for you this week by Deborah Ann. It's titled Encourage One Another. Encourage one another. Hold someone up in prayer. Let others know how much for them you really care. Listen to their problems. Feel their aches and pains. Help them to see that Jesus has his hand on the reins. Bring comfort to a friend. Lift their sagging feelings. Remind them that God is still into inner healings. Help them to be stronger in their trust and belief. Assure them the Holy Spirit will bring their soul relief. Encourage one another. Support the downtrodden. People just need to know they haven't been forgotten. She was inspired, you know, to write that poem after reading the verse that we quoted earlier. But here is the King James Version, 1 Thessalonians 5:11. Wherefore, comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even as also ye do. Well, it's time for us to go. And we thank you so much for listening. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
We do have you in our prayers. And if you have a prayer request, private message us on Facebook at J Sadie Gray, G-R-A-Y, or on our website, jsadiegray.com. And we're going to leave you now with Hezekiah Walker with a self-encouraging song titled, I'll Make It. Have a blessed week.
Come on, everybody, put your hands on this. Come on. Whoa. Put your hands on it. Pass the heads and pass the keys.